वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ पुरुषोत्तम पाठक। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू एक्सरसाइज 11.3 ऑफ मैथ्स फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 6। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड गॉन थ्रू एक्सरसाइज 11.2। आई हैड टाउट यू हाउ टू यूज द वेरिएबल्स। दिस एक्सरसाइज इज ऑल्सो वेरी सिमिलर टू दैट वन। Some new things we will come to learn in this chapter. Say, if you look at the exercise 11.3, one number sum, that is in the page number 233 of your maths NCERT book. See, make up as many expressions with numbers, no variables. Take care, we don't need to use the variables in this sum, as you can form from three numbers. You can from three numbers 5, 7, and 8. Every number should be used, not more than once. So we have to use the numbers only once. Use only addition, subtraction, and multiplication. So no division is required. Hints is also given there. So 5 plus 8 minus 7, 5 minus 8 minus 7, 5 into 8 plus 7. Similarly, 5 into 8 minus 7 also you can write. As these things has been three examples, three things are given as 5 plus 8 minus 7. Another one is 5 minus 8 minus 7. The third one was 5 into 8 plus 7. The next one, 5 into 8, not 9. Instead of plus, minus 7. See, come to the next step. Plus sign is used here and minus sign is used here. We can use all three plus signs also. Instead of using bracket, keep out the 5 from the bracket. 5 plus 8 plus 7. And so on. You can make so many numbers using such type of signs. Try to make as much as you can and count them up. Come to the second sum. Which of the following are expressions with numbers only? I think if you look at this sum, a number. Let me rub it. In the two number sum, A is in the A number, we need to find the expressions with numbers only. Y plus 3 variable is used here, we will not consider. B number, 7 into 20 minus 8 z is once again there. So this is not also not the expression without variable. These are with variable. Yeah, in the C number. C number is 5 into 21 minus 7 plus 7 into 2. Find out, is there any variable here? No. So this term will be counted. This expression will be counted. Similarly, D number will be counted. D number is only 5. E number once again contains variable, F number contains variable, and G number also contains variable P. So no other, only two. We got, they are without variables. Come to the three number sum. identify the expression addition, subtraction, division, multiplication in the following expressions and tell how the expressions have been formed. See, if you go to the one number, A number sum, in the A number, Z plus 1, comma, Z minus 1, let me write the Z like this only, Z plus 1, Z minus 1, Y plus 17, Y minus 17, addition, subtraction, here addition and subtraction. So this expression is made, the expression is made using how identify the operations in forming the polynomial expression is still how the expression have been formed. The expression is formed using addition was clear, subtraction was clear. Here also only addition and subtraction, multiplication, division is not applicable. So expression is formed using addition and subtraction. In this way, find out the another expressions also in the B number. Multiplication and division are used. In the C number, multiplication, addition and subtraction, three things are used. Go for the D number, you can decide yourself. Come to the 4 number. Give expressions for the following cases. In the very first class of the chapter 11, I had explained you what is algebraic expression, and in this chapter we are going through those expressions, but not yet we have learned how to prepare, how to express the algebraic term, how to write the expressions of the given situation. Given situations are here in the 4 number. See, A number, 7 added to P. So 7 and added to P means 7 plus P. You can write 7 plus P or P plus 7. Both are right here. Whatever you take. Come to the B number. 7 subtracted from P. So it will be P minus 7. Because 7 is subtracted from P. Similarly, you will solve A, B, C, D, yeah, in the C number, C. It is 7, P multiplied by 7. So, P multiplied by 7, we don't need to write the variable first. We will write first the constant term. And as in algebra, we don't need to write the sign of multiplication. Only we will write 7p, we got C number, and so on. One more I will show you. C at the G number, minus P divided by 5, so minus P by 5. In this way you can change the expressions. Come to the next sum. Once again you are asked to give the expressions. See, some of them I will solve for you. look at the sum number 5 in the page number 1234. Give expressions in the following cases. A number, that is 11 added to 2m. We can write 2m plus 11 because 11 is added to 2m. B, 11 subtracted from 2m. 2m minus 11. You will do the B number yourself. 5 times y. B number you will do yourself. Come to the C number. 5 times y to which 3 is added. 5y. 5 times y and 3 is added plus 3. 5 times y from which 3 is subtracted instead of plus. The next one, D number, is minus 3. Instead of plus, you will mention your minus sign. And E number, y is multiplied by 8. C E number, y and multiplied by minus 8 once again. Remind the thing I had told you, that variable will not appear first, the constant term will appear first, that is minus 8y. In this way, the next y is multiplied by minus 8, similar situation, and then 5 is added, plus 5, you will get the app number, and so on. Try to solve the remaining sums of 5 number yourself. Come to the 6 number. Form expressions using T and 4. Use not more than one number operations. Every of expressions must have T in it. To solve the A number, T and 4 is given. So we I am explaining the 6 number here only. 234 only, A number. T and 4 is given. So we can write T plus 4, T minus 4, 4 minus T, 4 T, T by 4, and 4 by T. This much I could think. If you could think more than this, you can go for. I don't think that you will get anything more than this. Addition, as it is cumulative, and 4 T, it is cumulative. So only division will appear twice and subtraction will appear twice. So how many expressions you got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 expressions we could form in the A number situation. Look at the B number. Form expressions using Y, 2 and S. I had done for T and 4. Try to do it for Y, 2 and 7 both. Every expression must have Y in it, as variable is compulsory. You have to write everywhere. In every expression you have to use Y. Try to do it yourself. Of course you will be able to solve it. And in the next class I will explain you exercise 11.4 also. Thank you very much.